100 grams.
Okay.
With that partnership.
All right. So in 2019, December of 2019, I moved to Atlanta to really just pursue music. And when I got to Atlanta, it was like something I've never experienced before. Like, I've never seen black just wealth in on a level, like in every single aspect. And during my time there, I auditioned for Making the Band, which is a show from back in the day that Diddy created. And I auditioned, for Lorianne Gibson, Diddy's three sons, Monica, and then P from QC, the label. And I made it. I made it past the first day. So I'm like, oh my God, what does this mean? Like, you know, I'm like, no, I'm not even supposed to be here. Like, I'm not even supposed to be doing this, to be honest. And then the next day, was the dance part, and then I made it past that. So I made it to the top 30 in Atlanta, but they still had to go to other cities. So there was going to be, like, there were going to be more eliminations, but I'm going through, like, and I can talk about it now because it didn't happen, you know what I'm saying? But it's like, I couldn't say anything about it. But we were going through, like, the interviews, everything, like the Skype interview, everything, like the whole nine. The next week, literally, like, the next week, they shut Atlanta down because of COVID. That's when it just like really was like, you know, like, nah, we gotta shut the whole production down. So I felt like, oh my God, I feel like I was this close to something. You know what I'm saying? Like this close to something. But then right after that, I'm like, if I audition against all these people that were probably better than me, to be honest, could sing better than me, could probably dance better than me, it was something that I had inside of me that they saw that they wanted. So I'm like, I need to start taking it more serious. Like, you know, really start taking, cause singing came before everything. Singing came before art, to be honest with you. But I just was so afraid to pursue it. But anyway, I do that, and then shortly after that, I released my first single, Retro Tens. And then people started paying attention, taking me serious, like, oh, she do art. Like, I ain't know she know how to sing. So, like, I feel like people wasn't taking me serious. Like, they was like, all right, she sing, but, you know, I don't know. But then people really just started, like, oh, dang, like, Jay have talent. Like, you know, Jay is, like, really serious about what she doing. So I just kept going. I never heard anything else about like the Making a Band situation, but I actually met Dawn Richard, who was one of the original members of Making a Band, randomly. I met her, I was shooting content in my neighborhood, and she was setting up for her her vegan company, Papa Ted's. I just walked up to her, I'm like, hey Dawn, I'm like, you don't know me, you know, but I just auditioned for Making a Band, and she just immediately, like, took me under her wing, like off the dump. Like, it wasn't, like, just immediately. Took me under her wing, and then we formed a relationship through art. And then she knew what I was doing. She knew what, you know, where I'm heading. And then I feel like she just gave me knowledge, just dropped gems, just actually got me my first mural, like, with Adult Swim. So it's, like, for a person like that, it's all ties in together, what I'm saying, for a person like that, of that stature and of that experience, to take her time, you know, out to come back to the city and help local talent, is like, people don't do that. You know, you don't find that. Like, you don't find that, like, really anywhere. So I feel like that's a person who walks the walk and talks the talk, well, and when she does what she does, you know? And I feel like all that ties back into, fast forward, come back home for a while, still, the pandemic is still going on, so I'm still doing that. And then a year later, I go back to Atlanta to just finish working on my EP. So after I finish my mural, I go back to Atlanta to work on my EP. And then Cortez Bryant, he is from New Orleans, from my neighborhood, is basically pretty much like a family friend, like a big brother. And he just hit me up on Instagram. He was like, Jay, you gotta come out here like and do a mural. And I'm like, oh, I'm gonna be out there anyway. So I'm like, you know, I'm gonna be out here. We're gonna sit down and like, we're gonna chop it up. I go by him, he's like, Jay, what you working on, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, I just finished recording. He's like, let me hear what you're doing. And I'm like, all right. And he heard it, he like, play it again. I'm like, you for real? He was like, yeah, play it again. And I'm like, he was like, I want to distribute your music. So I'm like, you playing? I'm like, don't play with me. Like, I don't got time to be playing. Like, I'm doing, you know, I'm doing these things like on my own, trying to, you know, be the independent artist, but it's hard. Like, it's not easy. So that went from there. And then I, you know, have a deal with Blueprint Distro. So they are my distribution company. And it's really great because I get to just aside from that, I just get to be my own artist. Like, I'm an independent artist still. You know, people hear distribution and they hear like, oh, you're like on a major label, but that's not the case. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm day-to-day hands-on with everything I do, every single thing I do. And it's good to have support. Like, you have that backing, but it's still like, I'm in charge of my career. Like, nobody's in charge of what I do. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, for me, I love that because I'm an independent person, just all around. And I think that, I believe that I'm gonna go where I need to go, whatever that is, you know, whatever God, you know, foresees for my life. I see me, you know, being one of the top songwriters in the industry because I write. I'm a writer. Like, you know, I write all my music. I sing too, and I do all those other things too, but I'm a writer. Like, you know, at the end of the day, singer as well. But at the end of the day, singing could not work out. You get one shot. Like, you know, and, you know, you get one shot at it. Like, you don't get to be, it's like with, that's like with any sport. Like, you get one shot to be in the NFL, one shot to go pro. Like, that doesn't last forever. So I just know that. Like, I know that, like,
so do you know, have, like, a goal? Like, is it, like, multiple goals that you have, or is it your main goal to eventually just be this great songwriter?
I have a lot of goals, to be honest. But my main goals are, like, they are to create, continue to create, because I can never, like, retire from that. So continue to be an artist. That's number one. You know, win awards, go on and do great things in music. Become, you know, one of, I guess, the best songwriters, you know, of our generation as well. And I want to go back to school to get my master's to become an art professor as well, because I was teaching at Southern for a while. And I want to teach art. Like, I want to go back and give what was given to me as an art student. And then just maybe coach, maybe do some coaching on the side. I don't know. I just have a lot of things I want to do. And of course, open a gallery, open an art gallery. So it's like all of those things, like, all of those things I want to do.
So all of those ambitions, yeah. I know I asked you about, you know, would you tell your younger self, what would you tell others, like the youth in general? You know, having these ambitions, and like you also mentioned earlier, you know, anything's possible, you know, as long as you do the work. Yeah. What advice would you give to the younger generation that are trying to find themselves and do what they want to do?
The advice that I would give to the younger generation is to, one, you have to have a foundation. Whatever that foundation is, whatever you want to call it, you know, I call what I call my creator God. So it's like whatever you call it, whatever you want to call it, you have to be rooted in that, because at the end of the day, your family can't do it for you, your friends can't do it for you, not even you can do it all the way for you. You know, like, we're all vessels, but you have to lean on that, because when people, they clapping for you one day, and the moment you do something wrong, you're the worst enemy. It doesn't matter how great of a talent you are, you have to have some type of foundation. And the second thing I would say is to respect yourself. Like, I feel like you don't have to be what everybody else is to make it. You can be who you are and still thrive and still go to the next level. And the third thing I would say is to work hard. Don't expect anything from anybody. Like, nobody owes any of us anything. Like, I'm responsible for my life and everything that's to come of it. I'm an entrepreneur, so I eat what I kill. If I'm not on the hunt, I'm not eating. Just point blank period. And I decided to take on that role. You know, I could have had any job. I could have, you know, been in any position as far as working a 9-to-5, but I chose to do that. And with that comes a great level of discipline. So if you're not ready to work 10 times harder than everybody, then keep your 9-to-5 too. Like, don't just be so quick to quit your job because it's the cool thing to do because you want to be a boss. Because being a boss is one thing. Being a leader is what you really want to become. And to create wealth for not just yourself, but for other people. And if you want to be the only one in the room that's the best, then you're going to have to go back to like the drawing board, because that's not what it's about, you know? And so that's what I would tell the younger generation, just to like, just be rooted in something that is bigger than yourself, you know? That's it.
Cool. If you don't got any last words, tell people where to find you at.
Okay. You can find me on social media. My Instagram is The Artist Jade. I have a Twitter, but you can take this point out. No, I ain't got to say my Twitter, because everything is The Artist Jade. Everything is The Artist Jade. I also have a website, which is jade1991.com. And then all my music is streaming on all platforms. So you can find me on YouTube, Spotify, Tidal, Apple Music, and yeah, just support, you know. Check me out, you know. Do a little song for me. Stream the music, spread it, just do something, you know, but thank you. And I want to shout out to Devin. Thank you so much for having me. Like, it's an honor to be in your beautiful store and to be, like, you know, the support of your series. And you have my support. Thank you.
Only in New Orleans.